I've been passing through the marquee. It's going to be quite a job. I've got the job not only in sort of talking to them, you know, asking them different things. Jenny's going to explain where they come from and what their ambitions are. It's up to you, our judges tonight, to pick these young ladies out, and we hope they're going to be, we hope there's going to be lots of surprises for the young girls at the end of the evening. But I think that maybe it would be right for me to introduce our judges at the start of the show. We've got a very wonderful array of judges. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 judges sitting out here in front. So if I can just take them from the top, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like first of all to introduce Miss Jane Holton of a famed dress hire agency. Jane. Next on the list, we have a gentleman by the name of Hack Mizbar, and he is the Jackson's general manager. Hack, where are you? Sitting down there. There you, Hack. James Page is the managing director, of course, of the Mountain Lakes Golf Course, ladies and gentlemen. James, there you are. And I'm sure that we owe you a debt of thanks. A big thank you for allowing the Bulworth Company to come here, and in order to, this week especially, to try and raise money and to raise the attention of lots of people in the area. We know you're doing lots of stuff throughout the whole week, culminating, I believe, with a golf match next Saturday with lots of famous names, and we'll tell the good folk about that a little bit later on. And I'm lucky enough to be doing my radio show tomorrow on Touch AM, so we'll give you a good plug, I promise you, tomorrow. But thanks very much for all the hard work you do, James. Thank you very much. And all his staff, too. Thanks very much. Okay, that's number three. Sharon Mills we have, and that's Mrs. Wales and Miss Cardiff Organiser. Where are you, Sharon? Right down there in the rear. Would you like to stand up, Tanner? Come on, stand up, let everybody see. You've been doing all the hard work and doing all the organizing, and it finally comes down to people like myself to try and decipher everything. I'm sure that we'll get it right, Sharon. Then we have John Gaskin, and he's the director of Collasagraphics. Come here. Just, I have to put different teeth in.
Collasagraphics. Is that right?
Collasagraphics. You see, there you are. Nice hand then for John. Where are you, John? John, will you stand up, John? There's a big bloke. Now give him a nice hand. That's it. Thank you, John. And we have a gentleman I've been speaking to, comes from north of this particular country of ours, not North Wales. He comes from the North Midlands, really. He comes from the north, from Yorkshire. He comes from Leeds, and I've been talking to him tonight in his own dialect. His name is Alex Broom, and he is the UK representative from the Queen of the World. So, Alex, take a cup. Now, where are you, Alex? There you are. Stand up, Alex. Don't be like Ronnie Corbett and say you are standing up. Sit down again. Thank you very much. A gentleman that does a lot of work in variety and is a great man in charity in the north of England. So welcome to... Is it the first time down here? Your first time down in Wales? Good. We hope it'll be a trip to remember. Now, last but not least, I have an old buddy of mine, and I've got to get this right, otherwise I'll have a clip around the ear hole. He's a former British and Commonwealth light heavyweight champion, ladies and gentlemen, a friend of mine and a good friend of yours, I know, Eddie Avoth. Come on, Eddie. There you are. Now, we're all set, more or less, in an evening which I think is going to be something which could well be an annual thing. Let's hope that it could be an annual event, this for Bulworth Cymru. And we're going to start. I'd like to ask my young friend here, who's going to share the platform with me tonight, just to say a few words. Jenny, come on. Just say a few words, Jenny. Come on. Right.
Well, I've done Panto with Stan, so I know he always hogs the mic. It's lovely to be here tonight. And the young girls, I think we should feel quite sorry for them, because they've got to appear in swimwear, and it's a pretty cold night. So first of all, they're going to come out all together. So give them a nice, warm round of applause. So I call the girls now out all together for you to have a look at them. Thank you.
Okay, everyone is ready. Here they come, ladies and gentlemen. A nice warm welcome for our girls. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Big round of applause for the girls. So I call on contestant one, please. Sharon Jaques. Would she please come along? Just give her a breather, because I think she's a bit tired after having all that parade. Would Sharon Jaques come along, please? Are you okay for music?
Young girl from Cardiff, and her name is Sharon Smith.
Coming in the bench, and she's 5'6". She's an A-level student, and she would like to be fluent in Welsh and Spanish. Our Sharon, Sharon Smith.
Right, number four contestant is Justina Ann Simpson, and she's from Bridgend. Justina Ann, she's 17 years of age and she's 5'5". Occupation is a student, and she has an ambition which she would like to be rich, famous, and successful. Well, I think we would all like to be like that. We wish you well anyway, Justina.
Sharon comes from Caerphilly. She's just 16 and a half. She's 5'7". She's a student and also wants to be a model.
Sharon's from Caerphilly. Right, then we're now at number six. We have Joanne Elizabeth Beezer from Coventry. Joanne Elizabeth is 16 and a half years of age, and she's 5'7" and a half. She's a student, and her ambition is to gain a degree in a university. That is our Joanna. Joanne Elizabeth Beezer.
And contestant number seven, Nicola Belinda Clash. Nicola also comes from Australia. 21, 5'2", and she's a hairdresser. Wants to own her own hairdressing salon. Let's hope she can one day.
We have Deborah Jenkins, and she's from Caerphilly. Deborah Jenkins from Caerphilly, 22 years of age, and she's 5'5". Occupation, production line, visual inspector at Bosch. Ambition to travel the world. Thank you, Deborah.
Contestant number eight, Deborah Jenkins. They're all from Caerphilly. Deborah's also from Caerphilly.
Hang on a minute, just one second. We're on the ship on there. Number nine.
I'm sorry.
This I know you shouldn't have had that.
Nicola Brown. No, sorry. Nicola Brown from Llanedd in Cardiff. Nicola's 18. She's 5'7". She's a trainee veterinary nurse. And she'd like to ride on the back of a killer whale.
Really?
Thank you, Nicola.
Eddie Amos, later on, the killer whale, that's him.
Thanks, Nicola.
Okay, number 10 then, Louise Davis. And she's from Cardiff Bay. Cardiff, Louise, 17 and a half years of age. And she's 5'8". Jewelry and dress from Fame Dress Hire Agency in Catalan Cardiff. There we have. Occupation then is a senior sales assistant in a natural beauty shop. She would like to be on the cover of Vogue. And she'd love to travel the world. That's our Louise.
I'll get it right now. Contestant number 11, Victoria Russo from Portobello. Victoria's 19. She's 5'5". She's a clerical and scientific officer. And she likes to enjoy life and succeed further. We wish her luck. Thank you, Victoria.
Thank you, Victoria. Number 12. Number 12 is Lisa Driscoll from Grangestone in Cardiff, age 26, height 5'7".
occupation beautician and promotion, specializing in wedding makeup. Ambition? To make up Princess Diana. Well, that's fair enough. She's coming down next. We can see Princess Diana. I feel Jenny will have a word with her. Anyway, we wish you well. You've got a lovely tan there, Lisa. You've got that out the back here today.
So this is Lucky 13, Julie Ann Baston. She's from Wichert in Cardiff. She's 27, 5'7", she's a student. And her ambition is to be a microbiologist. She works in a dermatology laboratory. Well, thank you, Julie Ann Baston.
Right, now we come to number 14, and it's Rachel Humphreys, Humphreys. 19 years of age, Rachel, 5'7", occupation secretary and part-time model. Ambition to have her own TV show. Snap. Thank you, Rachel.
But not least, Nicola Carr. Nicola comes from Canton in Cardiff. Nicola's 22, she's 5'4", and she's a housekeeper. And she'd very much like to travel Europe. Who wouldn't? I hope you'll realize your ambition, Nicola. Thank you very much. All of them.
On stage?
No, five of them. In a minute, I'll be having a little chat with her.
All right. I think Sharon will come back up to see you.
I hope she will.
Yeah.
She's better at the stairs than me.
Hang on now. First of all, we've already had Sharon then, and we have Sharon Smith from Cardiff, and she's 17. Sharon. Sharon has the funniest experience actually that Sharon has had when visiting Longleat Safari Park. A father had his window down and a camel put his head through the window. How about that? Anyway, they didn't get hold of you, so you're all right. We'll talk to you a little bit later on, Sharon.
And contestant number 3, Ruth Mappley from Blackwood. I'll be having a chat later with her about her funny experience. Thank you, Ruth.
Okay, Justina Ann Simpson from Bridgend, 17 years of age. Taking away now down towards the judges. The funniest experience, I got it written down here. Air lifted off the French Alps, it was. While skiing, falling off a banana boat and getting two black eyes. Hanging out a bedroom window and swearing to a friend. That's funny, isn't it? Anyway, tell me what you said later on.
And contestant number 5, Sharon Earnshaw. And I should mention that Sharon is wearing a gown from the famed dress hire agency in Canton in Cardiff. A beautiful dress for a beautiful lady. Thank you.
I've been able to announce the first one. Her name is Joanne Elizabeth Beezer from Pondy. Joanne's funniest experience today was after she phoned her mother from a phone box, she jumped into the wrong car. I wonder how many times that's happened. Anyway, there you are. Joanne Elizabeth Beezer from Pontypridd.
And contestant number 7, Nicola. And her funniest experience was being as a hairdresser, the water went off while colouring the hair of a member of staff. I know how she feels. She's 21 and she's a hairdresser. Thank you very much, Nicola.
Deborah Jenkins comes from Caerphilly. Not very far from here, down here all the way. 22 years of age, and her funniest experience was She tackled the army assault force in Brecon for charity. How about that, Eddie? The army assault force in Brecon? See you up there. Thank you very much, Deborah.
I'm contestant number 9, Nicola Brown from San Eddie and Cardiff. And her funniest experience was that she fainted during an operation in work while holding a cat's intestine. I should mention she's a trainee veterinary nurse.
Now, number 10, Louise Davis from Cardiff Bay. She's wearing jewellery and dress from a famed dress hire agency in Canton in Cardiff. Her funniest experience was watching her nephew and niece playing. They're always up to something, which makes her laugh. Thank you very much, Louise. Five ladies on stage now.
Yes, and it's contestant number 11, Victoria Rosser from Pontefract. And her funniest experience was that she walked down a catwalk of a fashion show and the audience laughed when she looked behind her. Her dress was tucked into her knickers.
There's no business like choking. Okay, now then we have contestant number 12, Lisa Driscoll from Grangetown. And her dress and jewelry come from famed dress and hire agency in Canton in Cardiff too. And very lovely they are. Now then, her funniest experience, sitting on hot tongs and burning her bottom. Well, we've expected later on, Lisa.
Church. She had a nasty experience when the zip burst on her dress in a local pub. That can happen to anyone else.
Then it was the farmer's arms.
Thank you, Julie.
Okay, Rachel Humphreys now from Pontypridd. Rachel, secretary, part-time model. Her funniest experience, she was locked out of the house one night and had to sleep on a deck chair in the greenhouse. Happy days are here again. Rachel.
And ladies and gentlemen, last but not least, contestant number 15 tonight, Nicola Carr from Canton in Cardiff. Nicola is also wearing a dress from the famed dress hire agency. She says her funniest experience is entering this competition. All the best. And very good luck to each and every one of them. A nice warm round of applause.
All right, for all the girls, thank you girls very much. I know it's difficult circumstances you have to get ready under. You want to look your best, we know that, and the wind's playing tricks for us all tonight.
Hello, Victoria. Now, you're also wearing a lovely dress from famed dress agency. Do you think that's a good idea that you can hire dresses today? Because they cost a bomb, don't they?
Well, I don't know how much this costs, but it looks absolutely wonderful.
It looks great on you. I must say, I should be popping along there next week. You can see me. So, you're a clerical and scientific officer?
That's right, yes.
So, what does it mean exactly?
Well, I actually work well. I actually am a scientist.
You're a scientist? Honest, you've got great fans out there.
I work for the Transfusion Centre. That's in Barbara, Cardiff. It's part of the NHS Directorate. And we deal with tissue typing and heart transplants, lung transplants, kidney transplants. I actually match patients up.
So are they going to pour down Reed Lava or are they going to build a new hospital? It's still going, isn't it?
They're actually closing Reed Lava 2 years' time, but we should be moving on to the University Hospital of Wales, which is in Heath Park.
You prefer that? Now it says here, oh, you had a very funny experience. You were walking down a catwalk and you realised that your dress was hooked into your underwear?
That's right, yes.
How did you get out of that?
Well, actually, I walked over to the end of the catwalk and we had our dresses specially made for ourselves. But because I was so short, they had to shorten ours. Well, I put on somebody else's dress at the time, and as I walked onto the catwalk, I saw the false reflections at the end, and I saw that my knickers, my feathers, my knickers, turned around a little. I wonder why everybody's laughing at me. As I made my final descent down to the team,
the one I've given
I actually realised what happened. Well, in the end, the compi said, new fashion for the next year. I bet that was great. Have you done any more of these competitions? You've done... I've done a lot of charity work or big events like this, but I've done it for friends.
Oh, I got 8 to 9.
Well, we wish you luck and all the best in your work. You're doing very good work anyway. Ladies and gentlemen, Victoria Rosser. Thank you very much.
Right, thank you, Victoria. Lisa Driscoll now, contestant number 12, also from Grangetown. Lisa. I'll come round here, Lisa. Here we are. Oh, right now. Grangetown, what part of Grangetown? Right. Oh, well. I used to work a lot down in the Grangetown area. When I started a group. Like I said, the judges have a very difficult job to do now and come up with some of the, I think it's about, is it, how many, 8, is it? So we're going to pick 8 now from the 15 and have a very difficult job. So we'll see you again in about 10 to 15 minutes. Thank you very much. In order to give our judges an opportunity just to see once again and listen to them once again, then we're going to bring them all up at the end in a line, and then there will be a little break of about 5 minutes while the judges then go upstairs and deliberate and come up with a final, 1, 2, 3. So that is what we will do now. We'll bring the young ladies on, and there are 9 because there was a tie. There were to be 8, but there are 9 now because there was a tie. And if I may just tell you the numbers, in case you're listening to me there with bated breath, we have number one coming back, number 2 is coming back, number 3 is coming back, number 6 is coming back, number 9 is coming back, number 10, 11, 12, and that's it, I think, maybe one more, 14, there you are. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Cardiff, there. Now we're going to bring them back on one at a time. We're not going to take too much time now. I'd like to ask back, if I may, number 1, and I'll talk to Sharon. Sharon Jaques from Newbridge. I'll just ask her one question, that's all. Come on, Sharon. Now, I've not had the pleasure of meeting you before because you're number one and you've been working over there with Jenny. I'm going to ask you one question. I've got it written down here. And I just want one question and I want a little answer from you if I can find the question. It is if, for argument's sake, you were stranded on a desert island now with three items, what would you like to take with you? What three items would you like to take on a desert island if we were to be stranded?
A nice man, plenty of money.
Eddie, that's you again, eh?
A mirror.
A mirror, a nice man with plenty of money, and a mirror.
And I think it would have to be my hairspray.
A hairspray. Well, that's not much to ask, is it? A nice man, a mirror, and a hairspray. Thank you very much indeed, lovely. Walk down there once again. A nice round of applause for the young lady. That's Sharon from Newbury.
Tonight, Sean Smith from Rubina, Cardiff. I'll just ask Sean a quick question. Congratulations anyway. Are you thrilled to be in the final?
I am.
Well, now I'm going to ask you, if you were chosen to represent your country in the Queen of the World, how would you promote your country?
As in Wales or Britain?
Oh, let's go for maybe Wales.
I'm not sure, perhaps I'd wear a leek on my head or...
You look very pretty with a leek on your head. We'll take that, right? We'll take it as a leek. Thank you very much. All the best to Sean. Thank you.
Thank you, Sean. Right, number three then, Ruth Mampoli. Come on, Ruth from Blackpool. Right, Ruth, I'm going to ask you a question, and it is, do you think that the royal family's personal life should be private, or do you think that the public should know exactly what people like Diana, Fergie, and so on, do you think the royal family should be a law unto themselves? What do you think?
I think you should have kept it left alone, because, I mean, everybody does things in their personal life, and, I mean, they're no different from anybody else, and they put their press and everything, should just keep out of it.
Lovely. Great. Well, that's a very good answer. Thank you very much, Ruth. Thank you, Ruth. Ruth from Blackwood.
And the next finalist tonight, Joanne Elizabeth Beezer from Pontypridd.
Hello, Joanne.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hi, Joanne. I'm going to ask you a quick question. If you were stranded on a desert island, which three items would you take with you?
Items?
Oh, whatever you want to have on a desert island.
I'd have to take Ryan, my boyfriend. My makeup. And I'd have to take my mother.
So, your mum, Ryan, and your makeup. Thank you very much. You're the best, Joanne. Thank you.
You're in trouble there, Ryan. Mum's going as well. Okay, well, I have young Nicola Brown. Do I have Nicola? Yes, I do. Nicola from Planetin. Nicola. Now then, you know there's been lots of controversy lately about the royal family, and just a little throwaway, actually, Princess Diane is going to be in this marquee this week. She's not going to be here, unfortunately, at Mountain Lakes, but this marquee is going to be dismantled and it's going to be moved up to Merthyr. And Princess Diane is actually going to be in the marquee that we're all in tonight. And bearing that in mind, I would like to ask you a question that lots of people are asking at the moment. Do you think, in your own mind, and please feel free to say what you think, that the royal family should pay taxes, including the Queen?
Definitely.
Definitely. There you are. Well, we wish you well tonight, my lovely. And I'm sure that we all feel the same way about the old tax problem. So a nice little hand then for Nicola. Nicola Brown from Planetin from Cardiff. Thank you, Nicola.
Getting into the final. You're the one who wants to be on Vogue.
you make it one day, I'm sure. I'm going to ask you a little question. If you were chosen to represent your country in the Queen of the World, how would you go about promoting your country? What would you do?
I'd probably sing the national anthem or something.
Great, that's a great answer. We'll have you singing the national anthem, Louise, and all the best in the competition. Thank you.
Thank you, Louise. Okay, I have Victoria now. Victoria, Russia, from Papa Prize. Come on, Victoria. Okay, well, we're only asking a very simple little question of each of our contestants tonight, and I think maybe, well, you may well have heard us ask that. If you were stranded on a desert island, and that doesn't include the flat homes, if you were stranded on a desert island, what three items could you or would you like to take with you?
Well, first of all, it'll have to be my mother.
Yeah! It'll have to be this mum. All right, mum. Right, you're on the way to the not the flat homes. You're on the way to a desert island.
Second thing is that I'll have to take a man, some sort of Chippendale or something.
One of the Chippendales. Have you ever been out there tonight?
I actually got one sitting down by there.
You've got your own Chippendale, that's great, lovely. What else?
And I think a stereo.
Stereo?
Yep.
You're a music lover?
I love music.
Well, there you are, that's three good things, mum. A Chippendale and a stereo. Lovely, thanks very much indeed, and good luck to you in the final, lovely, thank you.
And our next finalist tonight, Lisa Driscoll from Grangetown in Cardiff. I'm going to ask you a little question. Simple. Do you think the Queen should pay tax?
Yes, I do.
Yes, so do I. So, we're agreed on that one. Congratulations. And all the best tonight.
Thank you, Lisa. Now, finally we have contestant number 14, Rachel Humphreys. Rachel, we've spoken before, haven't we? Rachel, I'm going to ask you the question that we've asked quite a few of our contestants. First of all, congratulations for reaching this stage of the final. And after this, we have a little parade again. And our judges have a very difficult job, and they have to go away for 5 minutes to make sure they come up with the right answer. But you all deserve a prize tonight for this evening and this terrible weather outside and looking so lovely. You really do. So I'm going to just ask you something probably which you've heard us mention in earlier. If we were stranded on a desert island, what three things would you like to take?
My boyfriend's here, so I have to say my boyfriend.
Just because he's here? Do you have to say that just because he's here or because you want to take him with you?
I want to take
him. You want to take him.
A food hamper.
A food hamper? Hey, that's not a bad idea. You've got to eat, haven't you, as well? You know what I mean? Right.
And a shotgun to kill all the cannibals.
A shotgun to kill all the cannibals? You don't have cannibals on these islands. This is a desert island. Where do I get all these discs from? Never mind, you've got your boyfriend, a food hamper, and a shotgun. That's fair enough. Okay, well, let's hope you don't need the shotgun tonight, Rachel. Good luck to you and all the rest of the ladies. Come on, Rachel, from Ogwen-Williams. And if we could have all the young ladies now to come back on the stage again, please. Starting with our number one. And we'll have a nice lineup and we'll have a nice round of appreciation from you audience out there. Judges can get a look at the rear end of things. Now if you'd like to turn back around again to the judges, please. That's it. And
And would you kindly now lead off? That's it, lovely. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you, Rachel, and all you girls. And good luck to you all. A nice round of appreciation, ladies. Come on, for the girl. Come on, give them a nice hand. Now, let me remind you, we now will excuse our judges. Please give the judges a nice round of applause, too, because they need it now. We'll excuse you, judges, for 5 minutes while you go make your mind up. I'll remind the ladies and gentlemen of the prizes. Jenny, come over here with me a minute now. I've got the prizes here. You can read them from there. Third prize is £100 plus a Yves Saint Laurent beauty product. You get that. But what's the second one?
Oh, the second prize is £350 cash plus Yves Saint Laurent beauty products. Okay. And the first prize, Dan, that's the most important one, £200 cash and £100 worth of Yves Saint Laurent beauty pack or beauty gifts.
Yeah, what we mustn't forget, of course, is that Jackson's are going to make the members, or the three anyway, the first, second and third, they're going to give them, is it a 12 months membership for the club? That's terrific. Thanks very much indeed. The girls will be down the club there. And plus all the contestants will receive a Yves Saint Laurent gift. So there you are. So the girls are not going away empty-handed tonight. And we wish them all the very best. And don't forget what I mentioned earlier on. There are some raffle tickets to be sold. Money to be made. There are pound each. There's some very nice gifts to be given. Also, hot food is being served in the club. Coffee, whatever you want, in the club. So if you want to nip out and get something, make yourself scarce for a couple of minutes. I'm sure that in about 5 minutes' time we'll have the answer to the evening's competition, won't we? So we'll see you in about 5 minutes' time. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you.
Sending me a Valentine, birthday greetings.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, well, now a few little preliminaries before we come to the actual final. Now we have the ladies and we've got the result, but I'd just like to introduce one or two people, if I may, to you. I'd like to introduce a lady tonight who happens to be Mrs. England at this time, and who has donated quite a lot of the prizes for tonight. So may I ask for a nice welcome, please, for Laura White, Mrs. England, the present Mrs. England. There you are, Laura. Thank you very much indeed. That's lovely to see it. Marvellous. Have you enjoyed... Now, how long have you been doing that? I mean, your reign. How long has it lasted, or how long has it been going?
I became Mrs. England in March of this year, so...
Halfway through?
Halfway through, but I've just come back from Austria competing in the Mrs. Europe.
From Austria? Isn't that great? And you've still got another 6 months to go?
Still got another 6 months to go, open for engagement.
Enjoying it?
Wonderful.
Absolutely, you look good on it. I'd also like, if I may then, to introduce a young lady who is last year's Miss Cardiff, and who represented the Queen of the World. See, Miss, her name is Heidi Scurlock. Come on, Heidi, where are you? Nice hand for Heidi. Come on the front here. Last year's Miss Cardiff. There you are. Now then, Heidi, have you enjoyed your time as Miss Cardiff?
Been good.
Yeah. What about the girls? Now, the winner tonight, have you got anything you'd like to say to them?
Just enjoy yourself.
Just enjoy yourself. Did you go across to Austria to take part in the...
Well, I actually went to Taiwan, not last November, November before, and I had a wonderful experience, which I went with Alex Boone Promotions, and then I was fortunate enough to be put forward last year to go to Queen of Europe again, and I represented Wales, and I won the Queen of Photographic for Europe, so I'm very pleased about that.
Well, that's lovely. How about that? But a nice round of applause for that. Two beauties already. If you'd like to score over there and stand by Laura, then Heidi, if I may, and I'd just like to delay it just a little bit longer to remind you of the three events that are still to take place on Thursday night. We got the Bourbon Boys, we got a marvellous Cajun evening here on Thursday night, and that is £4, by the way, if you want to come along to that. And on Friday we've got the Jazz and Rhythm and Blues with Mike Harris, the Root Doctors. That's £5 a ticket, which includes a buffet and a meal of Cajun jambalaya, all the stuff. Dress which should be smart but casual. Then on Saturday, of course, after the golf, I mentioned this before, the one and only, the cabaret karaoke roadshow. And also there's going to be a music in the marquee, that is live music, and there's a fun casino, Las Vegas style, taking place as well. Now then, it gives me very great pleasure, and if only I could have a role on the drums, then obviously I would have one. What we're going to do is we're going to talk about this in reverse order, which is normal in this day and age of beauty contests. Reverse order, which means that the lady is number three coming on first. The third one actually has gone to number one, Sharon. Sharon Jaques from Newbridge. Come on, Sharon. And we're going to have a prize made by Mr. Phil Page, who is the marketing and sales director of the Mountain Lakes Club. There you are, Sharon. And a nice bunch of flowers too for you, sweetheart. And also, I think you've got something else coming to you as well. Look at that. From Laura, a nice little bag of goodies. And don't forget, you are being made a member of Jackson's Club in Cardiff for a 12-month, so we'll let you know about that a little bit later on. Okay? Now then. Number two there. And to receive the prize from Phil Page here, who is the marketing and sales director of the Mountain Lakes. The flowers are waiting, the black bag is waiting, and the check is waiting, and it's going to be given to number 14, Rachel Humphreys from Pontypridd. Rachel Humphreys. Rachel Humphreys from Rudwellen, I believe. I think you've got the check. You've got the flowers on the way. There are your flowers, my love. And the black bag. That's tremendous. Right now then. I wonder who will be occupying the seat. Here, the Queen. That is Miss Cardiff. Now, I'm going to leave the announcement to Jenny, who's probably had far more to do with beauty contests than I have. So, Jenny, would you like to take it from there?
Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Cardiff, 1992, Victoria Russell. Yeah!
Now, aren't these ladies lovely? I think we've got most of the picture that we need. Would the Queen like to sit? Oh, Miss Cardiff, would you like us to sit there? That's lovely. Maybe it's better if you have a few photographs with you sitting down and the rubber's up by your side. There you are. How are we doing for pictures? Okay, right, well, ladies and gentlemen, one more time then, please. May we have your appreciation for the judges. A nice round of applause for the judges, ladies and gentlemen. Not an easy job. A thankless job in the main. We would like to see them all winning, but hopefully all the girls will get a little present to go away with. And we have the three finalists, as I say here, the number three, two, and the winner. And we wish them well in whatever they do with their newly found position in the beauty world. Okay? Could we then have a nice round of applause? There's one picture over there, someone there. Yes, he's going to have a picture. That's it. Could we have a nice round of applause now for these girls and all the ones that took part then, please? Come on, you can do better than that. That's it, now you're talking. Right. There you are, and wish them well on this very special evening for them. And I say, well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. I will try and find out about the raffle in a moment or two and keep you involved in that. But meanwhile, like I said, there are hot meals you can get in the club. If you want some coffee, a few drinks, they're all here for you tonight. So may I say once again, girls, thanks a million for taking part. If we finish with the photographs, I think we have, you may well go and get your clothes off. No, hang on a minute, we'll want some more photographs, okay?
Love you.
And Phil would like to say a few words. Ladies and gentlemen, Phil Page, Marketing and Sales Director of the Mountain Lakes Golf Club.
Right, I won't keep everybody for long. Really what I'd like to say is that both James and myself, James being our Managing Director, we were both very, very happy to be able to sponsor this event this evening. We're very pleased with the turnout. We think it's been an excellent competition, and my heartiest congratulations go to our finalists. Excellent. What I'd like to say is that we promoted seven events, well, two events so far. There's another five to come. The next one's on Thursday and Friday. It's a jazz evening, and we really hope that, as it's all for charity, that these events are going to be well supported. Bobarth Cymru is a fantastic charity. It's based in Whitchurch, and I don't know whether any of the ladies and gentlemen present this evening have actually seen it, but it's really worth going down to have a look. It's a very well worth charity, and we really hope the object is to raise as much money as we possibly can for this fine effort. Before I go, I'd like to say just a few words of thanks to the Echo, who've supported our operation in advertising just recently, represented by Mr. Michael Dork sitting down there. Thank you very much. Thank you to the Echo. Mark Williams Associates are a marketing company, a good marketing company based in Cardiff, who put a lot of effort in into designing our adverts and things like that. Collasagraphics, an excellent company, again marketing company based in Cardiff, who sort of compile and create posters and wonderful things like that. Jackson's Nightclub, who've obviously presented the first, second and third with membership of the club, represented by Hank, its general manager over there. Famed Gowns and Dresses, who've obviously supplied all the dresses for the event. Mr. Bob Walsh of Cresta Caterers, who's obviously put a lot of work into this event, who's standing back over there, who can raise his hand if he likes. Thank you, Bob. And also, last but not least, the hostesses. Laura Avid Saint-Laurent, who's at the moment over there. Thank you, Laura. Yeah. Lynn and Jan, who've obviously done a lot of work this evening. Stan Stennett and Jenny Ogwen, who I think, and I'm sure you all think, have done an excellent job this evening. Totally unrehearsed. Thank you very, very much. And all the girls. I must say, 17 of the prettiest girls we've ever seen here. Thank you. And last but not least, everybody else for turning up. Thank you very much. And I thank you on behalf of the Bobarth Cymru Charity. Thank you very much for your support. Thank you.
Gives you the opportunity now just to clap our young ladies out of the marquee and back to their dressing room. Okay, thank you, girls.
And what better place to go babe spotting than right here?